Well, you'll never guess what a woman who was on a date got what she got from a random stranger. So it was a note written on a CVS receipt, or maybe one of those really long, like, printouts that come out.
The longest ever.
Right, so you could write a story on those. Well, anyways, the note reads, "Too many red flags, run, be safe, girl." The woman tweeted the picture saying it was given to her by a gay man sitting behind her. She also said she noticed the red flags too, but didn't feel like she was in danger. Have you ever passed a note if you were, Tori, worried about someone on a date?
No, but I 100% would. And here's the two things I would do. One, if I really did think this guy was, or girl, was causing danger, I would say something or slip a note. I'm someone that, as a woman, I would take a help from anyone. If someone's giving you a nod or in a parking lot, come with me, I'll walk you to your car, I'll take any help. It's scary out there. But two, if they talk badly about the person when they go to the bathroom, or if they're rude to the waiter, I would just be like, heads up. Not my type. That's how I would do it. I know I'm pushy. I'm a little bit Jewy in your face about it. I know that, a little nosy, but I want to help a person out.
If someone was rude to the waiter and they went to the bathroom, you would intrude on that date and say, hey.
I know, if they were rude to the waiter and then they went to the bathroom, I'd look over, yeah, and I'd be like, mm-mm.
What if
you're rude to the waiter 6 months, that's how you're treating the partner.
Does it matter, Jeff, that this was a coffee date?
She so would not do that.
I bet she would. Does it matter that this was a coffee date, not a dinner date? Because dinner dates are late at night. This is during the day. There's a lot of people around. Does that factor in or no?
No, but you know what does factor in? And I checked with Michael Dean on the side. Coming from a gay man and coming from a straight man are two different things. If a straight man goes
this
to me, hey, watch out for this. It'd be like, Tori, tell me, who's this crazy person behind me? And then if a gay man told me, I'd be like, it just carries more weight with me. I'd be like, huh.
Well, you know that he doesn't have
he
doesn't have any skin in the game.
No agenda.
You know, I do, and I have, you know, it's interesting, Sam, when everybody's talking, I thought about a situation. I'm not going to say the country, but some of my buddies were on a bus on an island nation.
Oh.
And we were like, let's get away from the resorts. We don't want to be these tourists. Let's go see the people. And we're on the bus, and we're about to get off at the stop, and the bus driver goes, if you get off the bus, they're going to slit your throat. Like, said it, like, to me and my boys, and we were like, sat right back down and took our American behinds right back to the
That's a good lookout.
We listened.
Right.
You know?
Did you guys know what their conversation was?
Yeah, something about DaBaby.
Yes. The two were loudly disagreeing about DaBaby. If you guys remember DaBaby, what he said, he had a homophobic rant about AIDS, and it rubbed a lot of people the wrong way. Not only the inaccuracy of it, but how it came off homophobic. So they were debating whether or not that was homophobic or not.
Ooh. How does that come up on a first date?
Yeah.
You should be like, hey, do you have any brothers?
Yeah. What does it say?
Sam, you read it.
What does it say?
What?
It says the girl at the end of the table, not this side, right? That side? Good. At the end of the table is insane. Be safe.
Who wrote that?
I'm going. Bye, Tori. We love you.
Hey, the waiter was mean. Break up with that guy.
Coming up on DBM.